Happy morning, dear students. School age child development describes the expected physical, emotional, and mental abilities of children aged between 6 to 12 years. During this period, observe difference in height, weight, build of children may be prominent. The language skills of children continues to grow. As always, safety is important in school age. Hi, this is Jansi. Today we are going to discuss about growth and development of school age children. First, we will discuss about what is growth, what is development, and which age group of the schooler is there. Okay, what steps we are going to discuss in this class is physical growth and development of the school age children, gross motor development, fine motor development, psychosexual development, and spiritual development, intellectual development, moral development, and needs of the schooler. These steps we are going to discuss today's class. Now start the class with growth. Definition of growth. What is growth here? It refers to an increase in physical size of the whole body or any of its parts. It is simply a quantitative change in the child's body. It can be measured by in kilograms, pounds, meters, and inches. Next, coming to the development, it refers to progressive increase in skills and capacity of function. It can be measured in qualitative. Next, who is the schooler? Here the school age child age is between 6 to 12 years. Okay, this is about growth and development of schooler. Okay, coming to the physical development or biological development of school age children. First one, height. The height formula of school age children is age in years into 6 plus 77 centimeters. If child's age is having 6 years, approximately 116 centimeters height should be there. If child age is 12 years, approximately height is 150 centimeters is there. Child height is increased per year, approximately 5 centimeters is there. Okay, here I will give one example. If child age is 7 years, we will follow that formula, that is age in years into 6 plus 77. We are taking 7 years of age group child. According to that formula, 7 years into 6 plus 77 is equal to approximately child is having 119 centimeters. This is about the height according to this formula. Okay, next one is weight. Weight formula of schooler is age in years into 7 minus 5 by 2 is equal to weight in kgs. Okay, if it is child is having 12 years, weight is 40 kgs is there. Every year child is increase their weight 2 to 3 kgs per year. Okay, according to above formula, weight formula, we have taken 7 years of age group children. Formula is what? Age in years into 7 minus 5 by 2. Here we are taking 7 years. 7 into 7 minus 5 by 2 is equal to 22 kgs approximately should be there in the 7th year. This is about the weight. Okay. Next, coming to, we will discuss about gross motor development of the schooler. Gross motor development of the schooler. In this, we are identify child's refined acquired skills is there and regular exercises child is doing. Child may runs, jumps, climbs and hops. Look at that first picture, children are doing the exercises. Look at the second picture, child is doing hops, means jumping with both legs. Here the gross motor, the muscles, skeletal system and nervous system is more active in the schoolers. Okay, this is about the gross motor development of school age children. Next, coming to the fine motor development of schooler. It may also vary widely. These skills can be affected the child's ability to write neatly, dress appropriately, and perform certain chores, such as doing household works. Example, bedding, cleaning the house. These fine motor activities are children is doing. Look at that picture. Child is able to write neatly. And child is grooming well. Look at that picture, first picture. Grooming very well. How that boy is wearing blazer. Look at that blazer. In that, one girl image is there. Okay, like that way schoolers are grooming. Okay, and then they are helping the household things or household activities. Look at the second picture. That boy is helping the household activities or household works. This is about the fine motor development of the schooler. Next, coming to the psychosocial development of the schooler. According to the Erikson, psychosocial development is sense of industry versus inferiority. Here, what is industry? Here, the industry means child is able to concrete themselves. And inferiority, at the same time, it is a negative feeling of the schooler, that is inferiority. Mostly in this age group, children are engaged task in real world. Highly motivate in purposeful activities. Example, include them in a planning of menu. Encourage the child to identify his potentiality. Who has to encourage their identify their potentials? Parents or teachers? Okay, they has to identify the and child's potentiality and encourage them. It is very needful for the schoolers. This is psychosocial development of the school age children. Mostly in this positive is industry, that is competency, how much child is able to perform themselves. Negative manner, it is inferiority. I will give one example. Here the positive is schoolers, they are doing the sums very well. Negative is inferiority. For example, in school age children, mostly they are playing the competition sports. When the school is paying more money and then they give some opportunities to their schoolers, that time they are having failures. What they are having in that situation, they get inferiority in front of the peers and then schoolmates. Okay, this is about the psychosocial development of schooler. Mostly the positive is industry, negative is inferiority. Okay, this is about psychosocial development according to Erik Erikson. Look at this picture. They are having industry, at the same time inferiority. Okay. Next, coming to the psychosexual development of schooler, according to the Sigmund Freud, that is latency phase. Here, mostly in this latency phase, associate with the same sex. Here, they are having groups. Mostly, they are following same groups only. Okay, look at this picture. Girls are mixing with their girls only. Here, the second point is, peer ignorance the opposite sex. They are ignore the opposite sex. For example, boys is ignore their opposite sex, that is girls. Girls is ignore their opposite sex means boys. Okay, this is about psychosexual development. Next, coming to the spiritual development. According to the fathers, spiritual development of schooler is mythical literal faith. Here, they are follows the ritual practices in the family and then societies. They believes others, differentiate their thinkings. Here, what is mythical literal faith means? Typically focus on the school age children. It is the child begins to understand the difference between the realities and make beliefs. During this stage, they are thinking how they will have strong belief and they has to justify. Okay, this is about the spiritual development of the schooler according to the Fowler's. What is that? Mythical literal faith. Okay, this is, look at the picture. Their beliefs are thus differentiate their thinking. Okay, coming to the next, moral development. According to the Kohlberg, the moral development of scholar is conventional morality. According to the Kohlberg, he given stage 3 and then stage 4 of conventional morality. First, we will discuss about stage 3 conventional morality, that is interpersonal co-coordinates, authority is respected. Here, in this third stage, mostly children is related with the concordance, authority only respected. For example, they are respect the authorized persons compared to another's. I will give one example. Okay, in their schools, their teachers are learned. Their qualification is just graduates. Their parents' qualification is post-graduation. But for whom they given respect means authority. Means their school teachers only they give respect compared to their parents. That is about the interpersonal concordance, authority is respected. Okay, this is about the third stage of conventional morality. Coming to the fourth stage of conventional morality, in this age group, law and order is orientation. Here the individual feels duty bound to maintain social orders. They obey rules for their own sake. They want to maintain order among their peers. Okay, that is about stage 3, stage 4, conventional morality. Okay, that is about conventional morality. All of you clear? Here, the what is conventional morality means mostly children is developed law and order orientation only. They obey rules for their own sake. Okay, these are the moral development activities according to the Kohlberg. Okay, next, coming to the intellectual development of scholar according to the Jean Piaget. That is concrete operational stage. In this concrete operational stage, the thinking of concrete operational children revolves around what they know and what they can experience through their sense, what in concrete. That is concrete operational stage. In this stage, children is able to understand, read, write, and do the arithmetic. Okay, and child is developing problem solving abilities and asking their questions. See in this picture, here the key cognitive accomplishment for a child in concrete operational stage, understanding the conservation. What is conservation? Here the conservation refers to the idea that an object does not change its weight, mass, volume or area when it change the shape or appearance. Here look at that picture, one example I kept. No, here the child's in front, glass of liquid is there. Here the liquid in different glasses, it can be mold or plasticine the shapes. For example, here how the glasses look like, one is wide, one is empty, one is narrowed. Okay, the quantity of liquid is same, but the space is occupies in that utilities, it may change. That time, the conservation can be understood by the scholar. This is about the conservation. The key cognitive accomplishment for a child in concrete operational stage, understanding the conservation. This is about the concrete operational stage. Okay? According to the Jean Piaget. All of you clear? This is about the intellectual development. Okay? Here, child is able to understand, read, write and do arithmetics. And developing problem-solving abilities, they are asking the questions. Okay, this is about intellectual development of scholar. Coming to the language of the scholar, language and speech development. Child, in this age group child, approximately 20,000 to 30,000 words they can able to speak out. And then they can explain or they can discuss these 20 to 30,000 of words. This is about language and speech of the schoolers. Next, coming to the play. Here, according to the Newhall, schooler having social or competitive play. Look at this picture. Girls are doing cooking, grooming and teaching. And boys are playing with kites, cycling and team sports also is there. This is about the competitive play is there in the schoolers. Okay, according to the Newhall. Next, coming to the nutrition of schoolers. Here we will discuss nutrients. How much is required for the schooler? Calories is 1600 to 2200 kilocalories per day is needed. Protein is 3 to 4 grams per kg per day is needed for the schoolers. Fats, 4 to 5 grams per kg per day is needed. Iron requirement, 15 to 20 milligrams per kg per day is needed. Vitamin A supplementation, that is 5000 international units is needed for day. This is about nutrients required for the schoolers. Okay, and coming to the dentition. In this dentition, schoolers, they are having shedding of the deciduous teeth and eruption of permanent teeth. Look at this picture. Shedding of the deciduous teeth and eruption of the permanent teeth. Look at that. Lower central incisors are erupted. Okay, this is about the dentitions. And next one is developmental problems in schoolers. What are the developmental problems is there in the schoolers? Means first one is truancy, fear of darkness, juvenile delinquency, school phobia, stealing, nail biting, teeth grinding, lying, ticks and hurting others. These are the developmental problems we are identifying in the schoolers. What is truancy? What is truancy means? It is having unexcused absence from school, amounting to more than half of the school years. That is called as truancy. They are keeping absence, unexcused absences. That is called as truancy. Mostly we have seen in the schoolers. And next one is fear of darkness. And nightmares also is having in school children. And third one is juvenile delinquency. Juvenile delinquency means criminal act committed by the children or teenagers, especially anyone under the 18 years of age group. They are violation of the law by a minor age between 10 to 17 years of age who have committed a criminal act. That is called as juvenile delinquency. Next one is school phobia. They having more phobia to going the school because they are unable to fulfill their tasks in school task. So they are having school phobia. Okay, next one is stealing. Stealing means take another person property without permission. That is called as stealing. In mostly school age children, they are taken another properties, that is pencils, pens and geometry box or their books. Mostly this stealing is there in the schools, school age children. And next one, developmental problem, nail biting, teeth grinding. Okay, because whenever child is having stress or tensions, that time automatically child is biting their nails. And then teeth grinding, whenever they are angry, they are stressed, that time teeth grinding also is happening. Okay, next one is lying. They are telling lies in schoolers. Okay, these and next one is tics. Tics means it also one of the developmental problem. Tics means a habitual spasmodic contraction of the muscles, most often in the face. Okay, these tics we have to see in the schoolers. Okay, and next one is hurting the others.
because of they are using more language, so they are hurting the others. Okay, these are the developmental problems mostly we have seen in the schoolers. Okay, next one, health problems. What are the health problems we have observed in the schoolers? Means motor vehicle accidents, drowning, burns, poisoning, bodily damage such as skin lesions. Okay, these are the health problems. Look at that picture, drowning, because they are more enthusiasm, they have to learn more situations, more events, so they doesn't know how to swim, but they going to swimming, so drowning also one of the health problems. And next one is look at this picture, poisoning. They doesn't know what happened with the consuming of the drugs, so child is getting poisoning. This is also one of the health problem. Okay, and wounds, scabies, dental caries, disorders of continence is there. Here the wounds and scabies also mostly one of the problems in schoolers. And dental caries. Dental caries means because of improper personal oral hygiene, child may get dental caries. And finally, disorder of continence. Okay, here child is unable to control the bladder sphincters. Mostly we have seen in the preschoolers and then schoolers. Okay, this also one of the health problem in schooling. Okay, these are the health problems for schoolers. All of you clear? Next, coming to the needs of the schooler. Meeting the nutritional needs, accident prevention, dental hygiene, exercise and sex education is needed for the schoolers. Okay, here early conservation about sex can be sent the message. The sex and sexuality are the healthy parts of the life. Everybody should explain. Means mostly teachers and then parents should educate their school age children. Here early conversation about sex can be send the message the sex and sexuality are healthy parts of the life. Here parents and then teacher has to educate the students. Sexuality is not just about sex, it is also the way your child feels about her developing the body parts. Okay, these are the needs. And love and security, meeting emotional needs, schooling, parenting, immunization and parental guidance is needed for the school age. Look at that picture, child is immunized. Okay, this is today's topic about growth and development of schooler. Thank you very much.
Conclude your work.